Hi everyone, welcome on board to Helpper.tv.
Abubakar Malami, Senior Advocate of Nigeria, who is supposed to interpret the law to the federal government of Nigeria, he is in court. The Minister of Justice and also the legal advisor to the federal government of Nigeria. But unfortunately, it is the opposite of it, as Malami does not even understand the law, or does he really understand the law, but he has to do the biddings of the dictator, Major General Muhammadu Buhari, retired President of Nigeria. If you're just stopping by, I say a very big welcome to you. If you're a returning subscriber, I say thank you for stopping by once again. Why don't we build up this family together by you tapping on the subscription button and the red notification icon bell below. It will alert you whenever videos such as this are dropped. And if you're already a member of this wonderful family, I say a very big thank you for the huge support. Now, Adeniyi Kuni, journalist and political analyst, sat down together with other people, other journalists, to dissect, to break down what is the brain mind of Major General Muhammadu Buhari and Abubakar Malami. In short, he calls them illiterate because they do not understand the interpretation of the law and they do not know how things are done. Do you think so? I believe they know how things are done, but they want to work opposite. That's just a simple truth of it. They want to work opposite. These people know what is on ground, but they are working tirelessly to make sure that self-determination group do not succeed. That is the reason why they did all they did with Mazen and the Kano, and also Sunday Ademo, Igbo, and anybody who speaks. All they need do is to arrest you and look for something to charge you with. They don't care keeping you in jail, keeping you in prison for 2-3 years until they are able to find something to pin on you. They have ways around it. You know how the police in Nigeria act, how they behave. They set you up, grab you, and pin something on you. That's how they work. It's the same thing with the federal government of Nigeria. There's nothing different. It's the same structure. It's the same way. They are the same group of people. Well, don't let me bore you more than this. Listen to the bombshell released one after the other.
Administration has deployed the Department of State Services
in
what they allege are clearly illegal nocturnal raids. They claim that the raids have been mainly targeted against the South separatist groups rather than the North terrorist bandits and kidnappers. Give us your assessment to
Well, in the first place, let me say this very clearly, that the foundation of every agitation in this country is injustice. The foundation, listen very carefully and put this in your scrapbook, I beg you. The foundation of every agitation, sir, is injustice. As I'm here, if I do a disservice to the woman I call my wife, she will protest and the house may be unlivable. If I'm unfair to any of my children and one observes, I don't think I'm going to enjoy their patronage as their father. The same thing with this country. Let us look at what the president said. The president of the country has attended 2 United Nations General Assembly. And let me put it in perspective. The one that was viral in 2015 was the fact that he was talking about the self-determination for the people of where? Of Palestine. One. The second one that has not gone viral was the case he has made, also on record, for the Rohingya Muslims that have been wrongly treated by the people of Burma, known as Myanmar. That is the second one that has not gone viral. If the president could make a case for them, why is the president or the leadership of this country uncomfortable with people asking for self-determination? Nigeria is a signatory to all the conventions available that permit or allows for self-determination. And why would anybody ask for self-determination? It is simply because the person feels, I am not being treated fairly in this marriage that has become very uncomfortable. That is one part of this conversation. Moving forward at the same time, when you are talking about the security operatives, do not forget that one of the most interesting parts of the role they played was to have gone to Kano to arrest somebody that said the president was going to take another wife. That is my own Department of State Service. Arresting people or arresting somebody who said the president wants to take another wife. In the first place, the president's religion allows him to take 4 wives. And if a man says the president was going to get married, I think that you could leave the police that also attend to civil issues to go and arrest him. The DSS should not be seen in such cases. Thirdly, There was something that happened when they paraded certain things they said they saw in Igbo's home. They saw the paraphernalia of his traditional religious worship. The last time I checked this constitution that I have issues with, freedom of conscience and religion is one. And you cannot circumscribe a man who has decided to be a traditional religious worshiper and protect himself as such by displaying the charms he found in his house. In the first place, the amulet, the charms, are the paraphernalia of his religion. Have you arrested somebody with rosary? Have you arrested somebody with tesbih? Why are you displaying all of those things? That is not part of what you should display. Then at the same time, the DSS came to his house. We have actually gone to places where I've sat with my lawyer friends that the way the DSS entered Igbo's house, was it proper? They said no. Was there an arrest warrant? Was there a search warrant? And don't forget that part of the issues described or described by the governor was that you cannot send people into a state when the chief executive is not aware. They went to Igbo's home. Governor Seyi Makinde was not aware of people coming to do such job. That is also a disrespect to the first citizen of the state, a disregard. Then let me also say this. When Afara Aku, the place of Nnamdi Kanu, was actually besieged by the military, do not also forget that the governor of that state was not aware of it. Let us walk within the confines of the law that we have sworn to uphold. These things are the reasons the governors of the South are saying certain things should not happen. And let me say this very clearly. The agitations may not abate, because if you think you have curbed one, other people are actually rising up and saying, no, treat people. Do you know that the Anglican Church in the East, in Anambra, for instance, according to certain things that I read recently, have stopped the use of the Nigerian flag, and of course they don't accommodate the national anthem again. That I read somewhere about 3 days or 48 hours ago. You see, when people see that you are not listening to them, they will find a way to get your attention. For instance, we are talking about the South-South people at the same time who are complaining. Has any respect been shown to the people of that region? Let us know that as students of political history, it took a lot of battle for them to even get the 13% derivation that they get today. And they are still telling you that the host communities are affected. Excuse me, people. I have traveled in the south side of the country. I've gone to the pipelines. I am not a media person that sits in Lagos and talk. I have gone to the creeks. I've gone to the waterways of Ahoda. I've seen this pipeline. And I see the stark poverty in the lives of these people.
Well,
let us treat this country with fairness and justice so agitations can stop. I appreciate this platform and thank you for having me.
Well, thank you so much for your contribution.
Thank you to those who have taken time to subscribe to this channel. And if you're yet to subscribe, kindly tap on that subscription button and also the red bell icon so you will be notified whenever videos such as this are uploaded.